Hello, good day, BS Accountancy. So we will be discussing past 12 income taxes. So past 12 or Philippine Accounting Standard 12 income taxes is the accounting standard that we use on how to properly present income tax information in the financial statement. So basically, it's not how we compute taxes because we are learning that in our tax subjects. Income taxes is more about how to properly present income tax information in our financial statements. Okay, so actually, we have two kinds of income. The two kinds of income that we have is the accounting income and taxable income. Ngayon, what usually happens kasi, sana pareho lang yan, dalawang yan. Yun nga lang kasi, pag pareho lang yan, dalawang yan, wala tayong pag-uusapan kung pareho lang sila. Okay? So, what we want to learn today is how do accounting income differ from taxable income, and those differences, how do we account them and record and report them in the financial statements? So, let's first differentiate an accounting income to a taxable income. Accounting income is the net income for the period before deducting income tax expense. It is the income computed in accordance with accounting standards. So accounting income is your net income in the income statement, which means na kung ano yung income mo na na-compute using the accounting standards, kung ano yung net income na pinipresent natin sa income statement, eto yun. Yun yung accounting income. However, we also have an income that we report in the income tax return and the income that we compute in accordance with tax laws, which is what we call taxable income. So taxable income is the income computed in accordance with tax laws or the net income that we report in the income tax return. So what happens is they are usually not equal with each other. And since they are not equal with each other, meron tayong tinatawag ngayon na difference. Ano yung difference nilang dalawa? Meron tayong two kinds of differences. We have permanent differences and temporary differences. So ano yung pinagkaiba ng dalawa? Dito muna tayo sa permanent differences. Permanent differences are non-taxable revenues or non-deductible expenses. Revenues na talagang hindi mo tataksan or expenses na talagang hindi mo pwedeng i-deduct kung tax ang pag-uusapan. So basically, what happens is they have no future tax consequences. So let me give you examples of them. Una, interest income on deposit. Alam naman nating lahat na ang interest income on deposit ay tinataksan natin as final tax. So kung income tax expense ang pag-uusapan natin, magiging non-taxable siya. Okay? Kasi nga, final tax po yung pinapataw natin sa interest income on deposit. Same with dividends received. Dividends received is also being under final tax din siya. So dividends received is also under final tax, kaya kung income tax expense ang pag-uusapan, it would also be a non-taxable permanent difference. And then we also have life insurance premium, where the entity is the beneficiary or an officer on an officer or employee. So basically, yung life insurance premium, pag entity daw po yung nagbayad niyan, that is a non-deductible expense. And then same with tax penalties, surcharges, and fines. Yung mga tax penalties, surcharges, and fines, yan po eh, kunyari, na-late ka ng bayad ng tax, syempre magkaka-penalty ka or other surcharges or fines. So syempre, hindi yan iaallow ng BIR na i-deduct mo for tax purposes. Kasi parang ang mindset natin dyan is, magpe-penalty na lang ako para lagi akong may pandedact sa tax. So, mapapababa pa yung tax mo, parang ganun, okay? So, yung mga permanent differences na yan can either be non-taxable, talagang hindi mo pwedeng taksan, or non-deductible, hindi mo pwedeng ibawas to arrive at taxable income. So, those are your permanent differences. Now, we also have what we call temporary differences. Temporary differences naman are differences between the carrying amount of an asset or liability and the tax base. Later, pag-uusapan natin yung difference ng carrying amount at saka ng tax base. Ngayon, the main difference between a permanent difference and a temporary difference is that temporary difference has a future tax consequences because we have what we call timing differences, okay? So we have the following examples. Pwedeng ang difference ay taxable temporary difference or deductible temporary difference. Ibig sabihin, pag taxable temporary difference, there is an amount that is taxable in the future. Kapag ka naman deductible temporary difference, there is an amount deductible in the future. When there is an amount taxable in the future, we have a deferred tax liability. And then, when there is an amount that is deductible in the future, that is a deferred tax asset. In short, ang deferred tax liability ay isang tax liability na magiging tax expense. Ito namang deferred tax asset ay pwede mong ipambawas ng tax, so parang nagiging tax benefit, kaya siya deferred tax asset. Okay, so yun po yung ating mga kinds ng difference. Now, let's talk about naman po yung carrying amount of an asset or liability versus the tax base. The carrying amount of an asset or liability is reported in accordance with accounting standards. So kung paano po tayo mag-compute, mag-record ng financial statements in accordance with our accounting standards, kung ano po yung carrying amount of the liability or asset, yun yung tinutukoy natin dito as the carrying amount. However, we have what we call the tax base, no? It is the amount of asset or liability that we record or report for tax purposes. Okay, so we have two kinds, the tax base of an asset or a tax base of a liability. The tax base of an asset are capitalized costs that are capitalized as an asset or deducted one time in the tax return. Okay? For example, meron tayong mga software development cost. Ang software development cost ay kinakapitalize natin as maybe an intangible asset. Ganon. Pero sa tax kasi, ang ginagawa natin, yung ginastos natin for the software development cost is deducted one time in the tax return. Okay? So magiging magkaiba sila. And then, kapag ka tax base of a liability naman ay, kunyari, for example, warranty liability. Okay? So, ang warranty liability is a liability in the balance sheet. Yun nga lang, inaallow lang ng tax, inaallow lang na i-deduct ang warranty kapag ka talaga nabayaran na siya ng company. So, magkaiba yung nagiging tax base natin. Okay? So, yun yung sinasabi nating tax base. Now, the general rule will be like this. If the carrying amount of the asset is greater than the tax base, we have a future taxable amount which will we have a deferred tax liability. When the carrying amount of the liability is less than the tax base, we also have a deferred tax liability. But when the carrying amount of the asset is less than the tax base, we have a deferred tax asset. And if the carrying amount of the liability is greater than the tax base, then we have a deferred tax asset. Ito po yung cheat sheet natin na pwede natin gamitin. Okay? Now, for the basic formulas, ito yung pwede natin gamitin. Accounting income plus or minus the effects of permanent differences equals income subject to tax. Plus or minus the effects of temporary differences is your taxable income. Now, from your taxable income, you multiply that to the tax rate in which our corporate income tax rate in the Philippines is 30%. Now, it depends on the problem kung anong gagamitin yung tax rate. Okay? So, taxable income multiplied by the tax rate is the current income tax expense. And then, all of your temporary differences multiplied by the tax rate, that is your deferred income tax expense. Pagsasamahin po natin yung na-compute nating current income tax expense plus deferred income tax expense equals total income tax expense. Yan na po yung total tax expense natin. Or pwede nyo rin pong makompute yung total income tax expense from the income subject to tax, which is ito, yung ginamit natin dito, this one, and then multiplied by the tax rate, that will also be your total income tax expense. So yan po yung ating mga formulas. Okay? So we are now ready to solve problems. Okay, so this is problem 1. Tantrum Company began operations at the beginning of the current year. At the end of the first year of operations, the entity reported 6 million income before income tax in the income statement but only 5,100,000 taxable income in the tax return. So take note, 6 million po yung ating accounting income and then 5,100,000 yung ating taxable income dun po sa tax return. Now, meron tayong difference na 900,000. Analysis of the 900,000 difference revealed that 500,000 was a permanent difference and 400,000 was a temporary tax liability difference related to your current asset. The enacted tax rate for the current and future years will be 30%. Let's compute for the current tax expense and the total income tax expense. Okay, so this will be our solution. Okay, ang unang tinatanong sa atin ay current tax expense. So ito lang yung formula natin. Yung taxable income natin na 5,100,000, which is this one, ito. Yung 5,100,000 natin na taxable income, multiply lang natin by 30%, yun na yung current tax expense natin. So, 1,530,000, the correct answer is letter B. And then, sa number 2 naman, diba, sinabi sa atin na meron daw tayong analysis of the difference na yung 900,000 daw, 500,000 daw doon is a permanent difference and then 400,000 naman daw po doon ay temporary tax liability. So, ang gagawin natin ay yung 400,000, mumultiply natin ng 30%, yun na po yung deferred tax expense natin na 120,000. Tapos, add natin yung current tax expense natin na 1,530,000. Yun na po yung total tax expense natin na 1,650,000. So, the answer for number 2 is letter C. Ngayon, paano natin kukunin to ng mas madali? Pwede rin yung ganitong approach. Ang accounting income natin ay 6 million. Minus natin yung permanent difference na 500,000. Ang income subject to tax natin ay 5,500,000. Pag minultiply natin siya diretso dun sa 30%, ang lalabas yung mismong total tax expense na agad na 1,650,000. So, these are our solutions for problem number 1. Okay, for problem number 2, Viking Company reported pre-tax income of 1 million in the income statement for the current year. Tapos binigyan tayo ng mga items na magkaiba sa tax return at saka sa accounting records. So, meron tayong rent income, depreciation, payment of penalty, and then premiums on officer's life insurance. Okay, so in answering problems like this, dapat i-determine natin alin dito yung permanent difference, ano yung taxable difference. So, ganito gagawin natin. Yung rent income tsaka depreciation, yan yung iyong temporary difference. Yung payment of penalty at tsaka premiums on officer's life insurance, yan naman yung ating permanent difference. Ang tanong sa atin, current income tax expense at tsaka total tax expense. Okay, so this will be our solution. We start with your pre-tax accounting income of 1 million. Add back penalty natin na 10,000. Bakit in-add back yung penalty na 10,000? Sabi nga natin kanina, kapag ka penalty na binayaran mo, hindi mo pwedeng ipang-deduct yun as expense in your tax return. So, i-add back natin yung 10,000. And then, premium on insurance is also non-deductible expense. So, i-re-add natin yung 90,000. Kaya, ang income natin subject to tax would be 1,100,000. Tapos, ngayon, check natin ngayon yung mga temporary difference natin. Let's first start with your rent income. Yung rent income natin, ang sabi sa accounting records, meron daw 120,000. Pero ang nasa tax return natin, 70,000. Ang isang ruling ganito, tingnan nyong mabuti. Ang accounting income natin as to rent is 120,000. Pero ang tax natin na income tungkol sa rent is 70,000. Pag mas malaki ang accounting income sa taxable income, meron tayong tax DTL or deferred tax liability. Paano naman natin siya i-relate sa carrying amount ng asset versus sa tax base? Tingnan niyo mabuti. The carrying amount of the asset is 120,000. Anong asset kaya ang related sa rent income? Pwedeng cash or accounts receivable. So, ibig sabihin, mas malaki pa rin siya sa tax base na 70,000. So, meron tayong deferred tax liability na 50,000. Pag may deferred tax liability, minaminus natin yon. Okay, dun naman tayo sa depreciation. Tingnan natin sa depreciation. Ang sabi sa accounting income, ang depreciation daw na minus mo ay 220,000. Pero pagdating sa tax, ang depreciation mo, 280,000. Mas malaki ang depreciation mo sa tax. So, ang mangyayari, parang ang dating, mas malaki ang income mo kung accounting ang pag-uusapan. Kasi ang depreciation mo sa kanya, 220,000 lang. So, parang ang dating, mas malaki ang depreciation expense sa tax, mas malaki ngayon ang income sa accounting. So, ang dating nito ngayon ay, accounting income would still be higher than the taxable income. Okay? So, we have a DTL of 60,000. So, ganito gagawin natin. Income subject to tax na 1,100,000 minus 50,000 minus 60,000, taxable income would be 990,000. Okay? So, taxable income natin na 990,000 times tax rate na 30%, that is your current tax expense of 297,000. So, for question number 1, the answer is letter C. Paano naman natin kukunin yung total tax expense? Ganito gagawin natin. Yung temporary difference natin, yung dalawa, yung DTL natin na 50,000 tsaka 60,000, pag-a-add din natin, so pareho siyang magiging 110,000. Times 30%, ang deferred tax expense natin, 33. Then add natin yung current tax expense natin kanina na 297,000, it will give you a total income tax expense of 330,000, which is, okay, so ang letter, ang number 2 natin, ang sagot ay letter D. Or pwede rin natin siyang kumpitin ng ganito. Income subject to tax ay 1,100,000, galing dito yon, galing dito, ito yon, 1,100,000. Multiply natin diretso sa 30% na tax rate, so total income tax expense natin, 330,000. Ito ang iyong checking kung tama yung ginawa mo. Okay? So this is our solution for problem number 2. Okay. Now let's solve problem number 3. Dunn Company reported in the income statement for the current year 900,000 income before provision for income tax. Tas binigyan tayo ng mga items na differences. Rent received in advance is 150,000. Interest income on time deposit is 200,000. Then, depreciation deducted for income tax purposes in excess of financial depreciation is 100,000. Ang ibig sabihin po niyan, mas mataas daw po yung depreciation mo sa income tax kesa sa depreciation mo in accounting. Then we have the income tax rate of 30%. Tinatanong po ulit tayo ng current income tax expense tsaka total tax expense. So this will be our solution. Pre-tax accounting income natin is 900,000. Tapos, ima-minus natin yung interest income on time deposit. Bakit natin ima-minus yung interest income from time deposit? Kasi siya ay subject to final tax. So, ang gagawin natin, ima-minus natin kasi non-taxable siya. So, 900,000 minus 200,000 is 700,000 income subject to tax. Una natin pag-usapan yung temporary difference na 150,000 na rent received in advance. Ang ginagawa natin sa accounting, pag may rent received in advance, diba, dinedebit lang natin yung cash pero unearned rent pa natin yan eh. Unearned revenue pa yan eh. So, hindi pa talaga yan accounting income. Okay? Pero, sa tax kasi, basta na-receive mo na yung 150,000, wala, income mo na yan. So, ang mangyayari sa atin dito ngayon is, ang taxable income natin, mas malaki kesa sa accounting income. At kapag kaganyan, isa po yung deferred tax asset. So, meron tayong deferred tax asset na 150,000, ia-add natin. Dito naman tayo ngayon sa depreciation. Ang nangyari kasi sa depreciation, mas malaki yung tax depreciation mo ng 100,000. So, ang mangyayari, kung malaki ang tax depreciation mo, yung accounting income mo ngayon ang mas malaki. Okay? And kapag ka ang accounting income ay mas malaki sa taxable income, isa po yung deferred tax liability. So, pa-minus po yun. Okay? So, 700,000 plus 150 minus 100 gives us a taxable income of 750,000. Multiply natin ng 30%, your current tax expense is 225,000, which is letter B. Tapos, ganito po ngayon. Yung problem natin ngayon kasi ay magkaiba. Isang deferred tax asset tsaka deferred tax liability na effect. So, ganito gagawin natin. Okay? So, yung future tax, future deductible amount natin na 150,000 at yung future taxable amount natin na 100,000, ko-compare natin. Kunin natin yung difference, 50,000. Kaso, ano mas malaki? DTA o DTL? Since mas malaki yung DTA, ang 50,000 natin, ang net effect niya ay isang deferred tax asset. So, pag minultiply natin ng 30%, itong future deductible amount natin, 50,000 times 30%, ang deferred tax asset natin or tax benefit na dating is 15,000. Dahil tax benefit ang dating niya, imbis na i-add natin, ganito ang solution natin ngayon. Current income tax expense natin is 225,000 minus yung tax benefit natin na 15,000. Ang total tax expense natin ay 210,000. So, ang sagot po natin sa number 2 ay letter C. Or, pwede rin pong ganito. Yung income subject to tax natin na 700,000, diretso lang po natin multiply ng 30%, yun po yung 210,000. So, that is our solution for problem number 3. Problem number 4. Caleb Company has 3 financial statement elements for which the year-end carrying amount is different from the tax base. Ang tinatanong lang po sa atin, total amount of future taxable difference. I-judge natin siya isa-isa. Okay? Yung equipment ay ang carrying amount ng asset, 200,000. Ang tax base ay 120,000. Mas malaki ang carrying amount ng asset kesa sa tax base. So, when the carrying amount of the asset is greater than the tax base, that is a future taxable difference. So, isa na po yan. Prepaid officer's insurance policy, ang carrying amount is 75,000. Pero diba, ang insurance policy sa officers kapag kumpanya nagbabayad ay isa po yung permanent difference. So, 75,000 is a permanent difference. Yung warranty liability naman po natin, mas malaki yung carrying amount sa tax base. At ang sabi natin, when the carrying amount of a liability is greater than the tax base, that is a future deductible difference. So, ang sagot lang po natin ay letter C. So, ito po yung solution. Last problem, problem number 5. ZEF Company prepared the following reconciliation of pre-tax financial statement income to taxable income for the first year of operation. So, binigyan po tayo ng pre-tax accounting income, tapos yung ating permanent difference na non-taxable interest, minus na po. Tapos, long-term loss accrual in excess of deductible amount, 100,000. So, since in-add po yan, that is a future deductible amount. And then, depreciation in excess of financial depreciation. So, minus po, ibig sabihin, future taxable amount po yan. Okay? Taxable income is 1,400,000. Okay. First question, what amount should be reported in the income tax expense current portion? So, ang tanong po ay current income tax expense. Remember po, pagka current income tax expense, taxable income lang po yun multiplied by the tax rate. So, 1,400,000 times 30% is 420,000, letter B. Number 2, deferred tax liability. Pag deferred tax liability po ang tinatanong sa inyo, mumultiply nyo lang po yung future taxable amount times 30%. So, ito po yung future taxable amount natin, 250,000 times 30%, 75,000, letter C. Number 3, what amount should be reported as deferred tax asset? Yun naman po, yung mga deferred tax asset, makukuha natin yan sa mga future deductible amount. So, ito po yung future deductible amount natin, yung 100,000. So, 100,000 times 30% is 30,000. Letter A. Number 4, what amount should be reported as total tax expense for the first year? So, kunin po natin yung current natin kanina na 420,000. Tapos, sa deferred po, dalawang effect. Isang DTL na 75, so i-add po natin yun. Then, isang DTA na 30,000, pa-minus naman po yun kasi tax benefit natin to. Okay, so 420 plus 75 minus 30 equals 465. Letter B. Or pwede rin po na pre-tax financial income natin is 1,600,000. Minus lang po natin yung non-taxable income na 50,000. So, income subject to tax is 550 times 30%, yun din po ang lalabas, 465,000. Okay? So, yan po ang ating total solution.